Please do this project with adult supervision. Hello, today we'll be showing you how to make the incredible edible cell project. So this is the cell membrane. The cell membrane is like a wall around the entire project, right? This is the cytoplasm, and it's going to be white icing, as if we're baking a cake, okay? These are going to be the ribosomes, right here, these little blueberry thingy-jigs, okay? And this is the nucleus, which is a gobstopper. So, what we're going to do today is we're going to bake these cakes right here. And we're going to take the white icing first, and we're going to put it around the baked cake, right? And then what we're going to do is we're going to take the cell membrane right here, and we're going to wrap it around the walls. And then we're going to take the nucleus and stick it right here, so near the middle, but not completely in the middle. And then we're going to take the mitochondrias and sprinkle them around. The vacuoles, however, will be quite hard to put around, so we're going to do the vacuoles first. And then we're going to do the ribosomes, and then the mitochondrion, and then the cytoplasm, okay? So, it'll be quite easy, you know? So, we're going to do that now, as soon as Sabrina puts it in the thing. You can tell that we're not doing a plant cell because the cake is not square, and we do not have the cryoplast. You know, you need to include the cryoplast of what you want it to be, and the cake or whatever you're making needs to be in a square formation. Okay.
Hold it.
Yay! All right.
Okay. Is it ready to bake?
Yeah.
50 degrees.
You need to bake this at 350 degrees if you're baking a cake.
Okay. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put both in. Right. So now we're gonna put the cake in the oven.
If you're baking a Pillsbury cake, you would know that you would want to cook it at 350 degrees. Please make sure you heat up the oven before you put it in. Heat up the oven until
it's exactly. Please read the directions. Okay, so let's put it in the oven. Okay. Watch out.
You know, Mom should put it in. She'd get the money.
I got it.
You're gonna burn your hand?
I'm not gonna burn my hand. It's all good.
Are we baking two cakes?
Mm-hmm.
What for? Okay. Now, as you can see, we've already put the cell into the oven over there, and it's already cooking. Now, you can tell that we're baking an animal cell because it's not square, and we have not included the cryoplast. Now, these are the ribosomes. Ribosomes are these kind of blueberry kind of things. These are mitochondrion. I need to remember that. They are, as you can see, bananas, because mitochondrions, mitochondrions look quite like jelly beans, but we decided not to do jelly beans. This is sort of like taffy. It's super ropes. So what we're going to do is we're going to put the super ropes around the metal wall.
So,
you can use this one. Put it right here.
Okay. Okay. So we just got. Not that hot. So. We just got the cake baked, and you know, it's ready to frost right now. So the metal wall is not going to be there because it's not edible, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to take this little cake, and while we're waiting for it to cool down, we're going to put it on the top of this cake right here, so it's like that, right? And then we're going to slide our hand down here, we're going to pick both of them up, and then we're going to drag it to the edge, right? We're going to put our hand under the cake, right? Be very careful about this because you may drop your cake. And we're going to flip it over so that way the cake will come out of the pan and it will no longer have the metal pan. Because, of course, none of us eats metal, right? Okay? Now, if it doesn't work that way, you can easily just flip it over again and you can use a knife and cut it out. Shaking it would be a better idea. because it'll save you some time. But there we go. So yeah, they're gonna let it cool, and then you're gonna put on the frosting, and then the ribosomes, and the nucleus, and the vacuum. Okay, so now that we're back, we finished putting on the cytoplasm, which is the white icing around this cake. And we're gonna go right into putting the nucleus first. So we're gonna put it just right here in the middle, just set it down perfectly right there in the middle. And then now that we're done with that, it's very quite easily placing the parts. You just need to be very careful, and if you mess up, that's all right. You can always take it back. But it may be a little bit hard trying to get the white icing off. So now this red type of a string thing is the cell wall or the cell membrane. Since we're doing an animal cell, it's the cell membrane. So we're going to wrap that around, and it's going to be the cell wall that holds the entire thing together. So it's going to be quite easy since it's already curved up into a round shape when we bought it. Getting the ingredients can be quite easy, and the ingredients can be found at a store found in the link in the description. So now that we've got that done, now we're going to go on to the vacuoles. So we're going to take the little vacuoles. We're going to put them around, and just regularly put them around. So you can put them, but I would recommend putting them wisely, not putting them together, and making sure that there's enough space to put more stuff like the ribosomes and the microdeuterians or whatever. So I'm gonna go right on to the ribosomes. So the ribosomes look quite like a type of spaghetti, like looking like this, standing up like that. So it's going to look a little bit like this, like that. So you're going to do that with every single ribosome, like forming it into a zigzag formation, like that, by just constantly folding it like that. Doing a lot of these things will be quite easy and quite fun. I do recommend doing this project if you're not doing it, doing it for just fun. And also, it's optional if you want to eat it if you are doing it. That would probably be included already in the text in your document. So now that I'm going on to the mitochondrias, or whatever, you're just going to place them wisely, but always place them down, not placing them up like this. Don't place them like that, because that's not how they work. So you will notice that it's not inside something like a watermelon. It's really because I made this model looking like it was cut in half like a cell in my textbook. So you might want to do that because it's easier, and that way you don't need to find a watermelon and cut it open in half, you know. And so yeah, it's a lot more easier, and plus you get to bake a cake. Or if you like Jell-O, you can make Jell-O. So now that I'm done, you've got a nice little, you know, the incredible edible cell project. It's done. Nice. Very nice project, huh? That's the finished project.